Hello, good morning students of class 12. Welcome to Professor's Virtual Class on Development Economics. And today, the topic of our discussion would be new industrial policy and liberalization. You just remember in our last class, we were just discussing about the three main policies that the planners of India adopted in order to compensate for the failures of the old industrial policy that continued right from 1950 to 1990. During those 40 years, at the end of 1990, the condition of Indian economy became such that almost 95% of our GDP was being paid as the interest of loans that we had at that time. So, obviously, this is quite a fatal situation for an economy, and the economy can never develop if such is the financial and economic condition of an economy. So, in order to rescue the economy from such a devastating situation, our planners decided to bring some serious changes in our industrial policy and as a curative thing, they developed the idea of liberalization, LPG, that is liberalization, privatization, and globalization. So, you can imagine, we have only for the stock of foreign exchange at our hand became so low during the 90s that means hardly we could pay for our imports for maximum 15 days. And in such a key situation, other countries of the world, they would never put trust on us and they would not like to entertain us with transactions or export and import. So, in order to rescue the economy, we developed liberalization, privatization, and globalization. And that time, we needed severely some money to rescue our economy. So, where could we get money? The condition of our economy was such that no country would advance any loan to us. So, in such a situation, the world economic bodies like the World Bank and the IMF, that is International Monetary Fund, they become handy. So, India requested for loan to World Bank and IMF, but listen, whenever we give loan to someone, before giving the loan, we always ensure that whether the man or the people or the person to whom we are giving loan has the capacity to pay it back or not. The same was the policy, and the IMF and the World Bank, they put certain conditions. Means it was not unconditional loan they provided to Indian government. They put certain conditions, and which is the liberalization, privatization, and globalization was the result and was the suggestion of International Monetary Fund and the World Bank. So, with that condition, they advanced the loans of $7 million, and with that money, India started its new journey towards development. So, today we are going to discuss about liberalization, and what is liberalization? What we would like to define the term liberalization? Liberalization means getting away from complexity. Means I am liberal, means I am quite flexible, I am not rigid. So I can consider different things in a different way. I am not fundamental. So that was the condition of Indian economy, and with the suggestion of IMF and World Bank, they had to follow the policy of liberalization. So after liberalization, during the liberalization, what were the changes and what were its effects? We are going to discuss today the effect of liberalization. So, one by one, we will discuss the effects of liberalization. First, what was the effect of liberalization in different sectors like financial sectors, like fiscal changes like foreign exchange reform and likely reform for changes in the area of trade and investment policy. So first we will start with financial sector. So financial, the word financial is related to the supply of money in the money market. That is financial. And on the other word, the word fiscal means it is strictly related to the income and expenditure of government. So we would have to discuss the financial sector changes. What were the changes that we brought at the beginning of the new investment policy that started in the year 1990? And what were the changes? The changes, as you can see here, the role of RBI. Prior to 1990, RBI was the controller of the economy. That means how the economy would roll on, how the what the economy would do and what would not do were strictly decided by RBI, and it was binding upon all the things, all the corporations, all the organizations that were part of Indian economy. But now, after the policy of labor, following the policy of implementation of the policy of liberalization, the role of RBI was shrink. That means now the Reserve Bank of India or the Central Bank was no more the controller of our economy, but it became only a facilitator of our economy or a body, an apex body that would only give suggestion how things should be and how things must be. It is not in the capacity or body of the RBI. It is after the policy, after the implementation of the policy of liberalization. So the role of RBI was seen, and now it became only a facilitator. And prior to 1990, it was the apex body that controlled the Indian economy. And the second point is privatization of banking sector. This was a landmark change that almost accelerated the pace of development of Indian economy. What? The privatization of banking sector. Prior to 1990, the private sector was not allowed to enter into the banking sector. Now, the government of India changed its policy and allowed private sector to enter into the banking service or banking sector. And the existing banks were encouraged to spread the number of their branches. You remember that prior to 1990, there was restriction and special permission was needed to open new branches of a certain bank. But now the restriction was removed and banks could open new branches, especially in rural areas, so that easily credit would be available to rural people. Then the third point is foreign investment. You know, during the 90s, the level of the stock of foreign exchange became so low with India that hardly we had the foreign exchange to facilitate import for 15 days, and it was a very fertile situation for an economy. So in order to attract foreign investment, with an ambition, with a goal to increase the stock of foreign exchange, the government made or changed certain existing policy, so that foreign investors would be attracted and come to India to invest. Then this is all about what the changes were brought in the financial sector. Now come to the second point, that is fiscal changes. Sorry. Students, I will remind you once again, the word fiscal means strictly related to budget of the government. Budget, an estimation of the entire income and expenditure of a current of a particular year is called the budget. So any policy related to budget is called fiscal policy. And what were the fiscal changes that our government brought in the year 1991? First one is increasing indirect tax. Indirect tax, in last year you have read about different types of tax, and once again I remind you, what is indirect tax? Indirect tax is such a tax that actually it is paid by someone else, but the financial burden falls upon someone else. For example, if we are buying some goods, then we are paying some tax on that goods. So, actually the government collects the tax from the producer itself. But actually the charge, the price is added, the tax, amount of tax is added to the price, and actually it is borne by the consumer. So, such tax is called indirect tax. So, increase in indirect tax means straightforward increase in the income of the government. So, thus, in order to increase the income of the government increase the amount of indirect tax. The second point is reduction of direct tax. So, what is direct tax? Direct tax is a tax that when someone pays it, he gets some direct benefit for the payment of that tax. So, earlier what happened, the amount of direct tax was too high. That's why there were cases, more cases of tax evasion. Tax evasion, that is called also tax theory. But the government reduced the amount of direct tax and it became very nominal, so that with the self-interest people started paying the amount of direct tax. Thus, the total income in terms of tax also increased. Then the third point is reform in the tax paying system. Earlier the system of payment of tax was very complex. That's why people usually tried to avoid that, and the cases of tax evasion was more. But now government made the process very simple, so that the collection from tax increased. Then the third point is that foreign exchange reforms. Related to foreign exchange, what were the reforms undertaken by the government of India in the year 1991? The first one is devaluation of domestic currency. In fact, we will read in more detail about devaluation, but in brief, let me tell you the meaning of devaluation. When the government of India willfully or deliberately reduce the exchange rate, increase the exchange rate, that means try to understand. Suppose earlier the exchange rate between rupees and dollar was 1:50. That means for $1 you have to pay 50 rupees. But now the government devalued the domestic currency, that means rupees, and now it became 1:60. For $1 we have to pay 60 rupees. So what are the government devalued the domestic currency, and what was the effect of devaluation on our export and import? Usually due to the process of devaluation, what happens? Export is encouraged and import is discouraged. So try to understand how export is encouraged. Suppose when the exchange rate was 1:50, a foreign buyer had to pay 50 rupee, or when the foreign buyer purchased goods of worth $1, then he was getting goods worth 50 rupees. Now, if the foreign buyer is spending $1, now he will be getting goods worth of 60 rupees. So obviously, the foreign buyer would try to purchase more and more from India, and foreigners purchasing from India means it is export from India. Thus, the devaluation, the process of devaluation encourages export and discourages import. Then, so in this way, when more export is there, more foreign exchange comes to our country and the stock of our foreign exchange rises. Then the third point is market forces control the economy. Earlier what happened, the government of India was following the policy of giving protection to indigenous producers. That's why innovation was almost stopped, and Indian products were not able to compete with foreign products because their quality was very low. But now the government, the government left the pricing policy to be fixed by the market forces of demand and supply. And the interaction, by the interaction of demand and supply, prices were started to be fixed. Then the fourth point is trade and investment policy reforms. In this, the first point is removal of quantitative restriction. You know, in the old economic policy or in the old industrial policy, we have read or discussed that the government of India imposed restriction on the amount of goods that could be purchased by Indian purchaser from foreign market and the amount of goods that can be sold to other countries by Indian producers. But now, as a matter of new policy, the restriction on import and export was totally abolished. The second point is reduction of tariff duty. So tariff duty, when we purchase something from other countries, we have to pay some amount of tax to the government. That is called tariff. And when the tariff duty is more, people were discouraged to purchase goods from other countries. But now as the tariff duty was reduced, people started buying more and more from other countries. Then the third point is removal of licensing policy and export duty. Earlier what happened in the old economic policy, there was the policy of licensing. The government of India was following the policy of licensing. Policy of licensing refers to that if I am a producer and if I want to produce something, then I have to obtain a license. And obtaining licensing was a very complex procedure. That's why producers were usually discouraged to start new ventures. But as now, in the new economic policy, new industrial policy, the process of licensing was abolished. So producers were encouraged to venture into newer and newer product. And export duty. When we sell to other countries, we have to pay some duty to government. That is called export duty. And more is the export duty, people will get discouraged to export or sell things to other countries. But now, as the export duty was totally removed, then people started selling more and more to other countries. Our export increased, and with an increase in our export, the stock of our foreign exchange also increased. So this is all about privatization. So go through the notes and copies, everything. And students, let me tell you one more thing, that today the Google Meet timing is 11, and every day it will be 11 itself. You have your economics on today, and on Wednesday you have got 11 class is there, and on Thursday your English class Google Meet is there. So all Google Meets will start from 11 and continue.